In the last episode, the Takeda clan under Takeda Katsuyori met the forces of the Oda and Tokugawa clan at Nagashino, resulting in one of the most significant battles in world history. At the end, the Takeda clan was utterly crippled, paving the way for Oda Nobunaga's domination of the land. Now, as Nobunaga consolidates his power, forces under Uesugi Kenshin will expand down towards Oda territory, resulting in the Battle of Todorigawa. After his victory against the Takeda in 1575, Oda Nobunaga was essentially tying up loose ends, most notably through the recapture of castles in Mino that had been seized by the Takeda. With the defeat of Takeda Katsuyori at Nagashino, he was now safe to reshift his focus back to the capture of the formidable Ikoiki Temple Fortress of Ishiyama Honganji. For 5 years now, the Oda had been attempting to crush the monks of Ishiyama. Yet, after countless attempts, the monks still appeared resilient as ever. By April of 1576, the Oda retainer Akichi Mitsuhide, who had been the main general in charge of the siege, launched a new offensive. Yet, once again, the attacks were driven off, and the mighty temple fortress remained secure. Nobunaga had Ishiyama surrounded, both on land and by blockade at sea. Even if his armies could not seize it, he was still confident that within time it would still fall due to a lack of incoming supplies. However, this is where the mighty Mori clan of the West finally enters the picture. Previously, before he was stripped of power, Shogun Ashikaga Yoshiaki had attempted to get the Mori to attack the Oda. Yet Daimyo Mori Teremoto had instead opted to wait, most likely due to external factors. Although now, Teremoto was finally ready to enter the fray. By August, using the powerful Mori Navy, he plowed through the Oda blockade at the first sea battle of Kizugawaguchi and began supporting the Ikoiki directly. Ishiyama would not fall anytime soon, and now, Nobunaga had another major enemy to contend with. Had the Mori and Ikoiki been the only concerns facing Nobunaga, that would have been one thing. Yet, as he was soon to find out, he was far more vulnerable. That same year, just to the north, the Uesugi were on the march. After the death of Takeda Shingen and Hojo Ujiyasu, the balance of power in the east had collapsed. Believing the opportunity to be right, the famed Uesugi Kenshin had begun to expand his territory west of his home province of Echigo. Previously, Kenshin had secured all of Echu, and by 1577, when civil war in Noto erupted within the Hatakeyama clan, Kenshin was quick to invade, taking the province for himself. Following this, Kenshin began pressing into Kaga, which was for the most part dominated by the Ikoiki. Nevertheless, he was quickly coming to the border of Oda territory. Kenshin was no friend to Nobunaga. In fact, the two powerful warlords could indeed be seen as enemies. Kenshin had never shown the drive to seize the capital that Shingen and Nobunaga had possessed, but now, with his territory growing closer to Kyoto, it was becoming more and more of a possibility that he could lead his army into the capital if he so desired. And of course, Nobunaga had every right to fear Kenshin doing so. In fact, by 1577, he was already considered somewhat of a legend. He had proven himself to be one of the greatest lords in the East, having halted Shingen at Kawanakajima and led successful campaigns into Kanto against the Hojo. Nobunaga needed to act quickly if he was to effectively respond to the Uesugi expansion. He gathered an army and set out to link up with forces under Shibata Katsuie and Maeda Toshie, who had already begun to march into Kenshin's territory. Upon seeing the strength of the Uesugi fortified position in Noto, they pulled back into Echizen, where they converged with Nobunaga. Together, their army numbered around 50,000. Opposite to them, Kenshin gathered a force around 30,000 and positioned himself at Matuo Castle near the Todori River in Kaga Province. Nobunaga amassed his soldiers across from Kenshin, once again with large numbers of matchlock tipo, and supposedly even cannons. No doubt, Nobunaga wished to deter Kenshin from holding out, showcasing that his forces were well equipped to deal with the Uesugi forces at range. He may have even hoped that Kenshin would simply pull back. Instead, Kenshin would showcase his fine-tuned strategic genius. Purposefully weakening his defensive line, Kenshin ordered a detachment of his samurai to begin making their way further up along the Tedorigawa. And for once, Nobunaga took the bait, believing that it was a perfect opportunity to sweep across the river and smash the Uesugi army while it was divided. He quickly ordered Shibata Katsuie to launch a full assault of Matsuo Castle. Yet, as Oda forces began to cross through the water, Kenshin sprung his trap, signaling his men to break the floodgates along the river, thereby releasing massive waves that carried away whole portions of the Oda army. Those that did manage to make it across to the opposite bank were immediately engaged by Uesugi samurai, who easily cut down the rattled Oda soldiers. As heavy casualties began to mount, Nobunaga quickly lost his nerve and ordered a full retreat back south towards Omi, in fear that Kenshin was going to swiftly continue the momentum and march directly on Kyoto. This caused a genuine crisis in the Oda camp as Nobunaga went into a great state of shock at the defeat of his massive northern army. However, in the aftermath, we can see that Kenshin may not have been so eager to march on the capital after all, as instead of pressing deeper into the region, he pulled back into Noto after his victory. Kenshin would go on to use the influence he earned through defeating the Oda to further solidify his power over his newly acquired territory. In the end, the Battle of Tedorigawa would go down as Kenshin's final major engagement, as just a year later, in 1578, he would pass away, most likely due to his alcoholic tendencies. This leaves many to speculate that had Kenshin continued his advance or even began his campaign sooner, he may have very likely succeeded in capturing Kyoto and defeating the Oda. Instead, the battle became a cruel reminder for Nobunaga that he was not invincible. Personally, I find the Battle of Tedorigawa to be incredibly interesting, as although Takeda Shingen did not get a chance to formally face Oda Nobunaga on the battlefield, his old rival Uesugi Kenshin did, giving us but a taste of what we might have seen, would Shingen have had the chance. So, what can we learn from this? After the defeat of the Takeda in 1575 at Nagashino, Nobunaga began to consolidate his already powerful position, turning his attention once more to the Ikuiki holdout at the formidable Ishiyama Honganji. Although we can also note that by 1576, the Mori began to formally oppose the Oda and lend much-needed aid to Ishiyama after breaking the Oda blockade. 1 year later, Uesugi Kenshin seized Noto province and began pressing into Kaga, threatening Oda positions. This caused Nobunaga to begin taking action against the Uesugi, eventually linking up with his armies to the north. Oda and Uesugi forces would face each other at Matsuo Castle along the Tedorigawa. Initially, Nobunaga had hoped with his impressive array of ranged weaponry, he would be able to drive away the Uesugi army. Yet, Kenshin would instead trick him into a full assault across the river, releasing the floodgates and causing the Oda to be nearly washed away while stragglers were cut down by a ready Uesugi army. Nobunaga would be decisively defeated, putting him into a state of shock. Afterwards, Kenshin would use his victory against the Oda to solidify his position. Yet, unfortunately, 1 year later, he would die. In the next episode, Nobunaga doubles down on his efforts to defeat the Ikuiki, while also taking the fight to his new Mori enemies. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to like, subscribe, and ring that notification bell if you enjoyed this video and found it to be most informative.